And that's the show. Let's see what we played there. The C.R. Thompson Mass Choir. That's what you just heard with I Can Make It. The Chicago Mass Choir before that with Holy Ghost Power from the album Shouting Down the Aisles.
Got original 1949 Dodge Pilot House pickup truck. Now, I really didn't know what a pilot house. I had to look it up. They're cool looking trucks. Now this is original AM radio out of it. And what we've done is a completely redone the case because it had a little rust on the inside. And polished all the front end, polished all the push buttons and everything. We've done a full Aurora Design conversion in 12 volt. It now has AM and FM stereo, auxiliary in, which is automatic. And I'll be demonstrating that. The radio will also scan your stations. Has voice ID, which is real cool in an AM radio. These are real neat. I like to do them. You have presets here, and they we got all them back working. Pull a cap off of it, and set your preset up. Like that, all you do is just turn it. Let's go to this one, let's set one. So you set it up, put your cap back on it.
For the tweed.
Roots Radio.
Funding ground for
test.
Take a small example.
Oh, there you go.
Need to set that one up, don't we?
Music City Roots
pull
changed
that
the game for Americana music in Nashville.
Let's set this one up.
Drew Franklin. Here on Sunday mornings, we pull two steps.
There we go.
Music City Roots.
Got them all working nice. This is your dial switch, so everything you want to do as far as controls, put it in dial. It will do it. This is your off and on. Has AM and FM stereo presets working. Four channels out, 45 watts a channel. It's got six pre-outs on it because this guy's going to be adding amps and subs. And he's going to have it little truck rocking because I've seen them trucks. You stick all that in a cab of a truck and you might have a little hearing problem when you get older. Got your regular bass and treble. Treble and bass. You also have balance and fader in your thing. I'll be demonstrating that in your toner control. Because he's going to want to balance it all out and stuff. And of course, your dial still works like it always did. All the way to the top.
My oh my.
Now, voice ID is neat because you're on FM, you got AM radio, you don't want to change the looks of it because it's too cool looking. Press this little button.
FM 107.9.
She'll give you station identification. It'll do it on every channel. Good sounding radio. Auxiliary in, which is automatic. This is your USB port harness you'll be getting with auxiliary in. USB thumb drive comes with it with this video on it, some music. Your auxiliary in plug in there, you can put any device on it, satellite radio, XM radio, your phone, CD changers, whatever's got a head that puts out a signal. Get a male-to-male cord with it. And all you do is plug it in, turn it on, and automatically changes over. USB, Bluetooth, hand-free phone calls, voice command, voice assistance. It will scan your stations, has voice ID, it's fully loaded. First thing we're going to do, if you want to go to AM radio, just turn the radio off and right back on. Takes you to AM radio, let's see what channel that is.
AM 650.
Pretty close 650. Turn it off and right back on, takes you right back to FM.
Or even home mortgages. FM.
And
back to dial. Now the radio, you have voice ID, AM and FM. It will scan for you. You can do it with this on dial. I like using the push button. All you gotta do is tap it four times. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Scanning for stations.
Now it's gonna start scanning for stations without the dial needle moving. And when you find a station you want to, you can turn this one time up the scale and it'll lock on it. You can actually push this three times and hold that station. So you can do this going down the road.
Could actually benefit more victims.
Even one judgment, one case could lower.
See, you like that station there, just pump it three times.
Station hold.
She'll hold it for you. That's pretty neat. I like it.
And number 29.
Right back to where we was at. Auxiliary in. Automatic, and put a little iPod on it. All you do is just plug your device in, bring it up, hit play. Using your 45 watts of channel coming out of the radio. You're gonna hook subs up in and amps, you really gonna kick. They're super clean. With a little love and a little help. Anytime you wanna go back to radio, just take that device and turn it off. You don't even have to unplug it. And if you don't touch your radio in 20 seconds, it'll automatically switch back to where we had it. We're gonna let it do that, but if you wanna shorten that 20 seconds, just turn it off and back on. We're gonna let it automatically change over. You don't even have to unplug your devices. I'm gonna go ahead and plug us so we move on. There we go, we're back. Back on the FM. Let's wanna check, make sure where we're at. Push it.
FM 89.5.
That's my favorite channel. To keep it that way. You play all the good stuff. Now we're going to let her help us up. We're going to do the initial pair up on your phone. It will take multiple devices. It'll always pick number one. So if your phone's one that's got all the music on it and you want to answer, listen to all the Alarm alerts, and it'll come in and beep in whatever you got when you get a text and go right back to radio. It's fully integrated. And that's the one you want to do first, and then you can do the other ones that might be barring your truck, which I doubt that happens. Let's let her help us out. We're gonna hold this button down, let her pair us up.
Bluetooth ready to pair.
Let's go to our Bluetooth settings. Showed up on her phone, all we gotta do is tap on it. She'll tell us when it's done.
Pairing completed. Bluetooth connected.
Alright, we're connected up. Now we're gonna shut the radio off, we're gonna do a little test. That way you shouldn't have to pair it up again unless you get a new phone or something's wrong with your phone, like mine is most of the time. I think that little gal I got in my phone, as far as speaking to me, I believe she drinks a lot. We'll find out here in a minute when we do some voice commands. You have a built-in mic, which is plenty of slack, because these are just no place to cut, to drill a hole to put a mic in, because most of it's glass and frame. And what we're going to do now is turn it back on and make sure she finds my phone.
Bluetooth connected.
That's what we want. So every time you get in the vehicle and got your phone, after you do the pair up, turn it on, it comes on, it'll be automatically logged up. Now a phone call comes in, no matter what the radio's doing, Bluetooth will override it. She'll come on and say incoming call. You can press this one time to answer the call or turn your needle dial up one click. Answer your call and talk. When you're done, let the phone hang up. It'll go back doing whatever you're doing. If you want to end the call, like some people you don't want to talk to, I do that a lot. Press it twice, turn it down on the dial. That will end your call. Let's do a voice command. put the little mic right up here. You don't have to. You can run that anywhere you want to. It's got plenty of cord on it. This I would do a voice command. Hold this button down, or you can actually turn the volume up twice. Let's do it this way. Turn it up twice. Play music. Going to music on my phone. Now, there's several ways to work your music. If you want to go advance up on your music, press it once. Twice to back up or repeat. Back up. You can also do it with a dial. Down. Up. Up. Down. That's how you do your music. This thing is set up so you don't have to have this in your phone. I'm sorry, my air compressor kicked on. Let me cut that off. I hate that when that happens. All right, it's set up so you don't have to have this in your phone in your hand while you're driving. You can put that in the glove box and operate it all from right here. Play music, call home, look up a restaurant, whatever you want to do by using voice command. So back up and repeat. If you're into the song, back up, forward. You can do it with the dial up, down. You can actually sum your phone up with this or this. Let's go back to radio. We're going to hold this down. Stop music. Put it in pause, right back to radio. Now I've been moving the dial, so. There we go. I was moving the dial, so it depends on, you know, when you're doing the dial deal. When you go back, you might not be on the same station because you've actually moved the dial to change your songs on your radio. That's why I like the push button. You can hide this dude anywhere on this lip of your dash, put it in an ashtray, which I don't even know if that 49 had ashtrays. Or cigarette lighters, but you can hide that anywhere and work it. That's how your Bluetooth and all work. Now we're back on radio. I'm going to show you how to do your balance and treble. I mean, treble and bass is automatic. Let's go into fader. We're going. It's easier to do it here than here. You can do it either way. It's in your instruction. Read your manual. This is how we're going to do it here. We're going to push this quick once and hold it.
Fader adjust.
Rears, fronts. As long as you're doing this, it will stay in that mode as long as you're moving it till you find what you like. Let's balance it out. Alright, stop moving it. She'll set it.
Fader set.
Alright. Let's go into balance, because you're back on treble and bass right now. Let's go back into balance. Let's go to balance right and left by pushing it twice and hold it.
Balance adjust.
There we go. Right side, left side. So you can set your four-way speakers or any of them up the way you want to. Let's balance it out. Stop moving it, she'll set it.
Balance set.
Now you're back on treble and bass. Alright, that's how that works. Now we're going to do the USB. You can hide this thing. A lot of people don't have to see it unless you want to charge your phone the only time. You got to take that out. I'm going to put a bunch of music on it. Redneck stuff. If you don't like it, you can take it off and put yours on it. But the file's already built for you. There's manuals on it. And the video on it. So if you lose your paper manuals, you've got them right here. All you do is plug it in, go straight to it. Now the same way as changing music as you do on your phone. Go up. Up. Back. Press it once to advance. Twice to back up or repeat. Thank you. That tells me somebody's at my front door. I have one of them rings. Now let's go back to music. It'll go right back after. See, it broke in and told me what was going on. Now it's going to go right back to music where we had it. Somebody's here delivering something. Let's see who it is. Well, we'll look here in a minute. All right. Advance your music back forward. Now, this is hid. If you got it stuck somewhere, you don't have to pull this out to go back to radio. Two ways of doing it. Hold this down 1 second. Put it in pause. Right back to radio. It'll cycle back around. Let's answer a phone call. R&B Vintage Radios, Richard. It don't matter, whatever time you want to, dear. I'm in the garage shooting a video.
Oh, I'm sorry.
All right, see you later. That's how you answer a call. Right back to radio. Is there any room? Now we put it in pause, went back to radio with this right here. You can hold it down another second. Right back to the thumb drive. Or you can use your volume knob. Turn it down twice, put it in pause, back to radio by turning it down twice. Up for Bluetooth, down for USB. Let's go back to radio. Next song is one that I back on radio. Let's turn it down again. Back to this. Back to your thumb drive. Now, if you put this in pause, it's kind of computer. It'll pick another song later on. If you put it in pause, stay there too long. Just like pulling it out, sticking it back in. Back to radio. That's your 1949 Dodge Pilot House pickup truck. AM radio, it cleaned up real nice, it looks good, and it sounds good. I appreciate you letting me do it for you. Thank you.